Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough! One last Trouble Center part before I get on to the progression of the game's story. So, you know what I should do on the way back? I always seem to forget to do this. Power up a partner, namely Miss Mouse here. Yeah, we may have just met, but you are still worthy of a power-up. I trust you as my partner to power you up in expectation that you will not destroy me. Shazubi! Voila! And she's got a new move, her attack power goes up, etc., etc. I'll show that off later on when the opportunity presents itself, I suppose. Anyway, Trouble Center, now. So, I looked into these troubles and I was mistaken as to the order that I have to do these. I could have actually done this before doing this one. I thought you actually needed to make something for Merle in this one, but you actually don't have to, so I was mistaken then. Anyway, I guess I'll do Mayor Dowler's first. Would you please deliver the Silver Club newsletter routing slip for me? Please come pick it up at my house in Twilight Town. Okie dokie. By the way, I noticed I said okie dokie a lot in the last part, so maybe I should stop saying that. Mayor! Mayor! I'm here for your trouble! Hey, how's it going? How are you? You accepted my trouble request. My, my. Now that's something. I hope you deliver the Silver Club newsletter routing slip to the Great Tree Elder. I used to bring it myself, but this hip is really growling at me. Would you take it from me? Oh, yeah. I shall. You got anything else to say? I was hoping to... I sure appreciate it. Okay. Don't forget to use your shortcut pipes! Yeah, unlocking these pipes, immensely handy. So here we are at the Great Tree. Let's go see the Elder. And probably get my head talked off. Super happy bouncy music time, go! Well, hey there, Mario, are you here to listen to me pontificate for a spell? No, I've got a routing slip for you. Why, this is a Silver Club newsletter routing slip. You came here to give to me this? Twilight Town's mayor sent you? My last youth fountain bath was there was nice, I recall. Well, this slip now needs to go to Petalburg Mayor, though my hernia is acting up. Say now, could you take this to the mayor of Petalburg for me? I'm counting on you. And I get it back. Okie dokie. Oh no, I said okie dokie again. Damn, bad habit. Must break. Bad habits. Must. Focus on commentary. Oh, I can't jump, or actually I can't walk over the roots. I'm not even going to cut over to the village because, if you recall, we're here. Yeah, thanks to these warp pipes, you don't have to worry about going through the routes of enemies and having to go through much of the sewers. We are just there in a snap. Well, maybe not a snap, but a little bit longer than a snap. But it would take even longer than that, taking the other way around.
Murphy, what can I do for you, young man?
Here's the routing slip.
The Silver Club approval slip? Is that from that puny elder? That old so-and-so? That reminds me, that super blood pressure gauge I borrowed from her was great! Since I'm the last one to sign this, it just needs to go back to Twilight Town's mayor. I seem to have caught a bit of a cold. Could you take it to that Twilight Town's mayor? Thanks, Murphy. Here's the routing slip.
Here's the routing slip. Hello, Mario. Did you deliver that last newsletter routing slip or what? Bloop. The mayor of Petalburg has a cold? Well, tarnations and diggly dang it. Oh, but you brought this back with you? Why, thanks. You sure are a lifesaver. Oh, and before I forget, here's your reward, Mario. Please take it. Woo! 30 coins! For the win! Notice how he's the only elder that is called Mario. Mario. We Silver Clubbers have been going strong for 20 years with our slogan. Age? What? We discuss longevity, secrets, and the like, you know. Maybe you'll join us in 20 years. Ha! Okay. Nope. Okay, I'm just joking about that one. Oh, as long as we're passing through here, you know what I should do? You know what I should do? You know what I should do? Roll through this hole. Look at this. Look at this. Hidden shine sprite in the back alley. As you can see, there's a nice little flower garden here. That's the door that leads over to the train. But as you can see, oh, there's no way out except for this hole right here. Where does this hole lead, though? What the? It's in a drawer! Yeah, that's just ridiculous. It leads to depressed rich Koopa here. Yet another day dwindles away while I loaf in bed, doing nothing. Oh, well, I sold so much stuff in internet auctions, I'm richer than ever. I guess it proves that money cannot buy happiness. Anyway, let's go back over to the Trouble Center. I thought that I had to do Troubles in a different order. Like, I thought I wasn't able to do the Merlee one before because I thought I needed to get something to Zesty first. But after looking into it more, I don't actually have to do that. But I'll do the order that I wanted to do, that I thought I wanted to do first, just to explain what my meaning to you right here. So I'm gonna start with Zesty and then go up to Merlee. I want you to go find a legendary cookbook for me. It's at a pretty scary place. There's no way at all gal I can eat it alone. Please come to my house in Rockport Square for details. Alright. So, I'm betting when I go there, she's just going to chew me out. I don't think she really put that trouble there because she needs trouble. She needs help. She probably put that there because she noticed that I'm the only one doing these troubles, and she loves chewing me out, so here I am. Chew me out, lady. Hey, you took on my trouble? Well, it's really important, so listen up, Mr. Klutz. Ages ago, there was this great legendary chef named Matria Delish. Rumor has it, you instantly become a better chef by reading his book. Unfortunately, it's an old book that's hard to find. Stars don't carry it. But I've recently heard that someone who used to live in Creepy Steeple had a copy. There are many secret rooms in Creepy Steeple, so it's molding there somewhere. I just have to get my hands on that book and read it. Help me out, Stumblebum! Want me to cook something up for you, Crumsy Clutchlet?
No, thank you.
Oh, what a complete letdown. I thought I could put my skills to the test. Okay, so let's go over to the Creepy Steeple now.
Why do crazy daisies hate me so much? I didn't do anything to them.
Anyway, we're back here at the Creepy Steeple. And you probably guessed it, but this room that holds the chest that I skipped out on earlier contains the treasure, and that's why I didn't want to get it earlier, because getting this before would have kind of put this out of context. So there's the cookbook that she was looking for. Now, I was told that there's a box in front of the Creepy Steeple that contains something, but I wasn't able to find it. I was told that it was above the stairs, so I jumped around the stairs and I couldn't find anything. Something tells me it's because I jumped at like an angle or something like that. Because you know, when you jump at an angle, if you hit the box on the side, it won't cause the box to trigger. But as you see, we got our sniffer Miss Mouse here, with her treasure sensing stuff, saying that there is indeed something here. So I'm going to hop on each of these steps. Oh, was that it? Yep. That's the only thing here, and it's just the one coin box. So yeah. I looked on maps and everything, and I just couldn't seem to find that. It wasn't even on maps and stuff like that. I guess it's an undocumented box in guides or something like that. I don't know. To show you what I mean, check this out. I got the official guide from Nintendo Power here. Official Nintendo Player's Guide. Look here, Creepy Steeple. It does not show that block whatsoever on the map. And come to think of it, it also does not show the block at, the one that's behind the tree there either as well. Well, since I'm going to end up in an inevitable battle, I might as well show off Miss Mouse's moves here. So let's swap over to her and do a love slap. Repeatedly tilt left and right to charge until it's full. And you get a long, long, stylish timing opportunity there. Alrighty. Please don't put us both to sleep. Please don't. The one I didn't want to fall asleep fell asleep because I have to demonstrate stuff and stuff, and she's asleep for 4 turns? What a ripoff! Oh, and I ran. Well, I guess it didn't really matter all that much anyway, because I wasn't going to be able to show off all the moves, so eh.
Alright, I brought the cookbook. Krabby cooks a lot.
Did you find that cookbook?
Yes.
Ah! That's it! That's the book by my Mushroom Delish! Give it here, quick! Ha! I see! Aha!
Doodly-doodle-da! Is she chopping up the book? What's going on? Don't fry the book!
Oh, the book is gone.
I've got it now! Just a glaze of mushroom with honey syrup for a yummy, hummy shroom! Brilliant! Now I can use recipes that require 2 ingredients! Now that's some book! Talk about effective! Thanks, Mr. Staggers! Take this as your reward! Woo! I got a honey shroom!
It's a combination between a mushroom and a honey syrup, which increases 5 HP and 5 FP, which can save turns in battle because you don't have to use them on individual turns rather than, you know, just using them in one turn. Rather than taking 2 turns to recover 5 flower points and 5 HP using a mushroom and honey syrup, you can instead use them as a one-turn deal.
Now I can use recipes that require 2 ingredients, so just ask me anytime!
And there's a lot of things that you can combine like that to save turns in battle, as well as just make some really powerful items in general. There's still a lot to cover with her, so I really don't feel like covering it now, so I'm just going to leave that for later.
I'm really going to put my soul into it and cook with a vengeance from this day on!
You know, she probably always did cook with a vengeance. Though she's probably not as much of an accomplished chef as she claimed before. I mean, who wouldn't think of using 2 ingredients to cook with? At least, you know, 2 or more ingredients to cook with, I should say. Anyway, next up, and the last trouble of this part, will be Merlie's Heartful Cake recipe. I want to make a heartful cake, but forgot the recipe for Mario's sake. I have to keep my shop open, so can you find me the recipe? I'm hoping. I first learned the recipe from Toasty. Yes, over in Petalburg, you see. Please meet me in the Charmer's Hut, beneath Rogueport. Hurry, hut! Yes, it's a rhyming sort of character here. I've never been over to Merlie's Hut, so I should probably show you the way rather than cut forward. All you have to do is go through this pipe like you would normally do, except rather than going through the bars of that pipe that you see on screen right there, there is a pipe a little bit further up. This one right here. And slip through. Oop, go in the pipe. And you appear in the background, if that wasn't obvious. Yeah, I know there's a chest there. That's something for a little bit later on. Alright, go inside this hut. Welcome to Merlie's Hut. Hello, welcome. I'm Merlie, underground, cute as can be, a fortune teller, that is me. Lucky for you coming here, I tell fortunes, have no fear. Let my mystical power tell of days to come more as well, for luck sits on my spells. What do you say, Mr. Guy? Want to give it a try? I'm going to say yes just to show you this here. I'm not going to actually buy anything, but you'll see. That's good, that's great. Choose your path to fate. Which path do you choose? Now, you'll see things of various prices here. Well, they don't change what you get out of it. All they do is increase the duration of what you get out of it. So each of these will have the same effect, except that they're longer the more you pay for each of these quote-unquote paths. And when you buy a path from her, what happens is that you can get more coins after battle. You can decrease damage that you take from attacks, increase your attack power, or double the star points you get after battle. All this stuff happens randomly. Since I'm not going to be doing much battling in this part, I'm going to skip out on this for now and do this later on when I'm actually going into some real deal battles later on. Anyway, obviously I'm not supposed to talk to her from this side of the table, apparently. I really must know how to bake a yummy, tasty, heartful cake. To Petalburg you must go. Ask Toasty all she knows. So, yeah, now I've got to go over to Petalburg in order to get the recipe. If you recall, she is in a house. I think it's just off to the right where the mayor's house is. Maybe, if I recall correctly, I just said recall twice there. On the way back, I should actually also go and show something. I was told before that I missed a box in this area in the room just before the thousand-year door, but I wasn't able to find the jumping around. Apparently you're just supposed to jump around next to this, you know, this invisible wall here that's cut out so you can see where you are. But I jumped around, couldn't really find anything. But then I was told to get out of my way. Come on over here. Get out of my way. There you go. Good boy. Now, I was told to start from here and just go straight down, and then the box should be... it's not here. So I guess the directions were wrong, but I'm going to look around here really quick with Miss Mouse, because let's just see here. There is something indeedly-do in here, so there's... So I wasn't necessarily misled. Maybe it's just somewhere that I just haven't bounced around yet. Stop getting in my way, please. Oh! So it's not in front of the gate, it's just off to the left of it. There's a pretty lucky badge there, I suppose. Again, going back to the guide, look at this map. It does not show the invisible block or badge anywhere on this page. This house right over here. Hey, how's it going?
Yes, hello. I'm Toasty. Did you need something? What? Do you want to make a heartful cake? And who asked you to? Really? Let's see. I know you need cake mix and rune powder. I wonder who Merly is making it for this time.
Yes, yes.
Say hi to Merly for me.
Oh yeah, go back to the Pianta Parlor and pick up that cake mix now. Well, another bag of cake mix. Hey you, give me my piantas back. Yes, yes. 9 piantas. Give me cake mix. Trading winnings. Cake mix. Yes, please. Back to Merly. On my way back, I'll now do my little explanation of why I thought I needed to do the cookbook side quest first. It's because I thought I had to make the cake myself, which of course requires multiple ingredient combinations to do so, but no, you actually don't have to do that. All you have to do is go back to Merly, tell the recipe, and give some cake mix over. So, did you find the recipe for Heartful Cake for little old me? Yes, yes, yes. Ah, I remember now. That's right, of course. Wow! Oh no, what shall I do? I have no cake mix. Boo-hoo! And I can't leave my shop here. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear, oh dear! I hate to ask, but could you please bring me some cake mix? I'm on my knees. Here's some cake mix. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you. You're the best. You passed my trouble test. Cannot make a cake without cake mix, right? No doubt. As you make a heartful cake, mix ruin powder well to make the cake mix properly bake. I'm going to make it tonight, and it will be out of sight. Then I'll charm someone right. Thanks so much to you, dear. Here is your reward. Here. 30 coins! Yeah! You know where I haven't been for a while? This shop! Dazzle! Yes, I would like to trade in some star pieces. I've got 59 of them in reserve here. Yeah! Look at all the options that I have now! Peekaboo might be a pretty nice badge to have if you aren't the kind of person who likes to tattle stuff, but for the sake of just keeping stuff for, you know, so I remember to tattle everything, I'm gonna leave this one out for now. And anyway, let's see what we can get here. How about... That seems like a pretty handy badge to have, so swap it out. It costs 7 badge points to get it, though. Why don't I just get the cheap old badge? Sure, I still gotta show off the sound effects of those things. I'm just trying to pick the most useful badges out of this, but it looks like that... doesn't really seem to be all that many... badges that I could really make, make more use out of than the badges that I already have now. But yeah, this is the entire point of getting star pieces, is to buy stuff from here. I guess I'll The Power Plus probably would be a pretty nice extra badge to have. And I'll bring it for the... get one for the partner as well. I'm gonna grab one of these, because there's some very expensive partner attacks. And Happy Flower. I think that's a new badge as well. Yay! Alright. All troubles up to this point are now completed, so that means I can get on with the actual game story in the next part. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you then.